Thank you. Led by a mysterious voice, Sora stepped through the door that marked the start of his journey. Sora, Riku, and I wanted to see the world beyond our island. One day, Sora came face to face with a man from another world. Meanwhile, Donald and Goofy received a letter from Mickey asking them to find the holder of a certain key.
We'll be right back.
fateful night, darkness consumed Destiny Islands. As Riku disappeared into the darkness, my heart managed to escape to safety inside Sora. The darkness overwhelmed Sora, and he awoke in an unfamiliar town.
Come on!
Having been chosen by the Keyblade, Sora teamed up with Donald and Goofy. The trio traveled together through many worlds, locking the world's keyholes in order to keep them safe from the encroaching darkness. Meanwhile, Riku awoke in the dark depths.
Thank you. Thank you.
With his heart clouded by darkness, Riku stood in Sora's way. As they fought, Sora realized that his power came from his friends, not his weapon. When Sora found out that my heart had been inside him all along, he saved me without sparing a thought for what might happen to him. Now it was my time to save him. As I wished for that strength, something incredible happened. Hoping that we would never be separated again, I gave Sora my lucky charm.
We'll be right back.
light emanating from Kingdom Hearts destroyed Ansem, the strongest darkness Sora faced. But the darkness behind the door still threatened to burst out at any moment. With Riku and Mickey on the inside and Sora on the outside, they sealed Kingdom Hearts from both sides. And so, Sora and his two friends continued on their journey.
Father, when we are old
continued his journey in search of Riku and Mickey, and found himself at Castle Oblivion. Using cards made from memories of the worlds they'd visited, the group continued deeper into the castle. Meanwhile, Riku awoke beneath the castle and was met by a mysterious voice. With Sora headed for the top floor, and Riku aiming for the ground floor, the two continued to climb, each on their own path. As Sora advanced through the castle, his memories started to fade. In exchange, new memories of Naminé grew clearer. It quickly became his goal to save her from where she was being held captive in the castle. Meanwhile, Riku was fighting the darkness within himself as he continued through the castle. Lying in wait to confront him was a boy who looked just like him, a replica of himself created by the organization. This replica was planted with false memories that caused him to stand in Sora's way.
Thank you.
Naminé had the power to overwrite the memories of Sora and those connected to him. The organization used this power for their own gain. Even after discovering the shocking truth that his memories of Naminé were fake, Sora still chose to protect her. He prepared for the final battle, eager to finally retrieve his lost memories. The battle at Castle Oblivion came to an end. To regain his memories, Sora would have to forget all about Naminé. He fell into a deep sleep, but not before leaving himself a reminder to thank her when he woke up. Meanwhile, Zexion decided that Riku had outlived his usefulness. From within a shroud of magic, Riku heard Naminé. Riku accepted the power of darkness without fear, and he used it to defeat both Zexion and the replica of himself. Naminé offered to use her powers to lock away the darkness in Riku's heart for good, but he refused, choosing instead to wield its power as his own. Riku and Mickey set out from Castle Oblivion, continuing along the path where darkness lies hidden within light, the road to dawn.